All right, we good.
Hey, bring that one for me. I don't know if I got any time.
Let's start back at 3. They sing the song of Moses, the servant of the Most High.
Yeah, that's talking about after the Americans get destroyed, them chariots come down. They're going to deliver us. They're going to deliver those who, you know what I'm saying, that praise the Lord in His name and kept His name. That's why the name of the Lord is very important. Keep going.
And the song of the Lamb saying, great and marvelous are thy works, Lord, power almighty. Just and true are thy ways, thou King of saints.
Right, you're going to see, the Lord's works is marvelous. Y'all going to see the Lord's works. You know what I'm saying? When them chariots come out, y'all see the chariots come out of the sky? You going to talk about marvelous. Okay, because the chariots was delivered the Israelites through the Exodus. You know, delivered them out of the hands of the Pharaoh. And that was a chariot, a so-called UFO that was leading the Israelites through the Red Sea. And we're going to see those marvelous works once again.
Who shall not fear thee, O Lord, and glorify thy name?
And glory, because you're supposed to glorify the name of the Lord. And the name of the Lord is not Jesus, okay? That's Greek. The Lord had a Hebrew name, okay? The Lord's name is not Jesus. The Lord's name is Yahweh Shai.
Wait, Jesus.
It's not Yahushua. It's not Yahshua. They think Yahshua sounds good because his English name is Joshua. So their little simple understanding and their simple brain and their simple ass mind think, oh, Joshua. Joshua don't sound nothing like Jesus. This shit ain't nowhere even similar. And look, and what do they call him in Greek? They call him Jesus Christ. Right? What is Christ? What is a Christ? Christ or Christos. Christos means what? Christos means to anoint with oil. It means to anoint with oil. But how do you say to anointed with oil in Hebrew? It's Messiah. Well, we say Messiah, but it's really Mashiach. Okay, the English way of saying is Messiah. So, Christos and Mashiach or Messiah are nowhere similar whatsoever, are they? That tells you the first part of his name, Jesus, ain't nowhere similar to the Hebrew. It's totally different. Greek is a total different language from Hebrew. That's why we call the Lord Yahweh Shai. We don't call him Jesus.
Hear you the Most High, but you don't mind people calling you misinterpreting your name. Man, that's crazy, man. Power want his name to be pronounced correctly.
Correctly.
You know? That's why we're going to have rod of iron to track the motherfucker inside the head.
Hey, that's why we proved it. You remember them old Greek texts, too? What the fuck?
Crack.
This is powerful, bro.
Jesus. Crack. Where did we get that power, man? Wait. What's his name?
Yeah, because the name don't let nobody fool you, man. The name of the Lord is very important. It's very, very important. Don't let nobody lie to you and deceive you. They smoking that good shit. God damn.
Damn.
They about to have me passing out.
Right. I got a contact right now. In the stone. She's going to get her head. She's going to get her head, bro.
Jake, bro. These motherfuckers.
Make that bus ride go comfortable.
Shit, man, that's bugging out. Shit, you might need to smoke that before you get on one of them buses. Shit. You don't know what you're going to see on the Dakota bus, boy. That's just an adventure. Man, I got on a Dakota bus the other day. This big fat. Big, it looked like an Edomite. This big fat.
Don't move.
What was that? This big fat 500-pound motherfucker walking on a bus. He stunk so bad. As soon as he got on the bus, everybody's heads went back like, whoo! And everybody just ran for the windows and started opening the windows up. We didn't want nobody even say nothing to him either, you know what I mean? You know Jake don't always be. If he's scared, you know what I mean? That wouldn't be mean to him.
probably motherfucker got bad life.
Yeah, you know, that's true too. You don't know. Could be his glands, you know what I mean? They blame it on the glands. You know how they do it.
Eating all that bad shit. Real. Oh Lord, and glorify thy name, for thou only art holy, for all nations shall come and worship before thee.
Yeah, all nations shall come and worship before thee. So there ain't gonna be no America, no other country existing side by side with the kingdom of heaven. So that's why when you say the Lord's Prayer, what do you say? Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. So every time you say the Lord's Prayer, you praying that America is destroyed.
That's right.
Because you want the Lord's kingdom to come. And if you saying that prayer, thy kingdom come, that you also admitting that his kingdom's not here yet, right? So people get mad at us because we say America's going to be destroyed, but y'all say the Lord's Prayer.
It is
going to
be destroyed.
It is going to be destroyed. It has to be destroyed.
I'm calling you. It's going to be destroyed because how much him now should I set it for?
Yep. This is all part of the scripts.
He already showed he ain't no liar. Everything he say comes to pass. My hands is freezing.
It is hard. The temperature dropped out here.
It's a wind. It's fucking wind. God damn.
Go ahead. Come on with it.
Isaiah.
Soon that wind will turn hot.
Isaiah 51:11.
The fiery tempest. Oh, go ahead.
It says, therefore the redeemed of Yahweh shall return and come with singing unto Zion, and everlasting joy shall be upon their head. They shall attain gladness and joy, and sorrow shall be sorrow, and mourning shall flee away.
Hey, read that again. That was a good scripture.
Isaiah 51:11, therefore the redeemed of Yahweh shall return.
The redeemed of the Lord shall return. Go ahead.
And come with singing unto Zion, and everlasting joy shall be upon their head. They shall attain gladness and joy, and sorrow and morning shall flee away.
Oh yeah, that's a yeah, it sure is.
Hey, yo, my man, you know you're a biblical Edomite.
What's that?
You know you're an Edomite.
I'm an Edomite?
Yeah, you know what an Edomite is?
I know it's from the Bible.
Yeah, it's a nation of people, right. You ain't never knew that? What you think your nationality is? White man?
From America.
You're American too?
What's the nation that I belong to? Yeah, sure.
Yeah, just do a Google of Petra Jordan. That was the ancient land of Seir. Petra Jordan?
Oh, okay.
You seen Petra Jordan? Yeah, you can see your ancient homeland.
Okay.
Petra Jordan. Did we have a sign out here?
Oh, yeah, it's right here.
Right. You can actually see it.
Yeah, like they use the same architecture
we
and everything.
We were brothers. We actually still are brothers, though. You know? But you are the evil brother.
I'm the evil brother?
Right, you're the evil brother.
Why am
the
I
mad
the evil
scientist.
Brother?
So the Lord made you that way. The Lord made you to be evil.
But you're not evil.
Right. Our people are doing evil. The majority of our people are doing evil because of the curses. But you were made to be evil.
But how come you're not evil?
Why? Because we're the righteous. We're Israelites. We're the biblical Israelites. We're the prince. That's what Israel means.
You believe in the Bible?
Of course not.
Which parts of it?
None.
Oh, see, there you go. You just testified.
Right.
Which part? See, you don't believe it.
Just like you hate us, the Lord hates you too. Yeah, well, you know. Slavery is supposed to be over, and you claim to be living at peace with us, but you're constantly passing laws to oppress us more and more. You know what I'm saying?
I don't pass the laws, but I do work.
Well, your nation, your people do.
Uh-oh, you're working
and the laws
court.
They pass,
we have a
you're,
nice thing,
you're benefiting from the laws your people pass.
He'll get
you know?
Locked up.
You're benefiting from them, you know?
Okay.
Right.
You work in a court, what kind of work you do over here?
I'm a staff attorney.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, make a good money.
Oh, so yeah, like a...
So city, you, yeah, it's okay, yeah.
You're like a public defender?
No, it's actually working for the judges.
Ooh.
Yeah, that would be nice to that guy.
Masons.
The Masons.
Mason.
You're not a Freemason, are you? He wouldn't tell you if he was.
Of course he wouldn't tell you if he was, man.
Yeah, exactly.
So he just first
rule.
Right. Yeah, y'all got
exactly.
Your first
nobody
rule.
Talks about
right.
Yeah, they all got their fraternal orders.
Okay,
might
be off topic.
Yeah, that's right.
What do you think about those niggas over here? Smoking weed and shit. What do you think about
that?
That's what they are, though. That's what they are.
African American.
See, those are the evil ones that we all speak about. The majority of us that are the evil ones.
Sure.
They're only evil because of the conditions they're living in. They chose to embrace it. You know? Like,
sorry.
Go on, man, with your question.
I'm sorry, what was your question?
What do you think about the African Americans? Like, do you love
them?
You know, some of the way you know, like, you know, smoking weed, killing people, do you love them?
Well, I don't know if I would wait smoking weed.
Behind closed doors, they animals, right? Come on, be honest.
What did the course play though?
Be a man to admit it, man. Come on. There's smoke, there's garbage, there's trash.
Human beings, not.
I know you see a lot of trash in there, don't you?
Of course you do.
I see people who are on hard times. I don't see no trash.
Huh?
I have love for my fellow human beings, regardless of
what. All right.
Human, you know what human means?
What is it?
It's color. Human means color. This is color. You know, you're not color. You don't have color. You know, you're translucent. You're the translucent man. You know, translucent man.
Uh-huh.
Your blood shows through your skin because it has no color. You're not a man of color.
Remember, what's that got to do?
You're not a human.
Whether or not anybody's trash.
No. We're saying you.
Jesus in the Bible tells you to love everybody, right?
Well, who loves everybody?
All your fellow human beings.
We're being peaceful with everybody, though.
Right, we've been peaceful with you.
Yeah, we've
been. You gotta have love in your heart. You can't call people.
We do got love in our hearts.
Well, actually, the Lord called people. He said it's a generation of serpents and vipers. You know what I mean? He said this is a wicked adulterous generation.
Hey, call women dogs, right?
Yeah, he called women dogs. So
who's the he in that?
There's a balance. There's a balance in everything. You know, there's a time to love and a time to hate, you know.
That's right.
Can't be stuck on stupid all day.
Which
just
is
loving true. Everybody. See where that ends. Right. What is it?
Yeah.
Stem
cell. Psalms 11:5. The Lord crying for righteous, but the wicked and him that loveth violence. So
hey. Oh yeah.
Right. Who's in charge of them banks that finance the militaries?
I mean, I think we finance the military.
The white man.
So let me ask you a question. You work in the court system. What is the elephant in the room?
What's the elephant?
Is how come a poor man could commit the same crime as a rich man, but the rich guy come in there with his, you know, his hotshot attorneys and everything, and just get a slap on the wrist. Now, is that justice?
No.
But that's reality, though, ain't it? It's like, you know, justice is for sale. I mean, you know what I mean? Not always.
When it happens, it's injustice, and then you try to do justice always, and, you know, possibly fall short.
I get to the way it appears to me is this country is set up for by criminals.
For and by.
It was created by terrorists. And they
wage
war against their king.
So.
You know, they wage war against their king. You know what I mean? Their fellow patriots.
So they thought they had a freedom.
So we're talking about justice, right? Well, what's justice to a nation of people that stole a whole land? And literally just slaughtered that Native American Indians. What's justice? Just speaking about justice to the same people, nation of people that came here and enslaved a whole nation of people in another land, brought them here, made them build up this country. What's justice for that?
It's a work in progress.
Well, Genesis 9:6. Whoso sheddeth man's blood, by man shall his blood be shed, for in the image of the Most High made he him.
That's right to the point right there. I wish that one's the numbers. We got numbers.
No,
where is that, right?
And Carl keeps his book at
him. One more.
You got one.
He's scared.
Revelation 13:10. He that leadeth into captivity is not going to captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here's the patience and the faith of the saints.
Remember they said, Gad,
just
be overtaken by troops. That was Esau, you know the truth. Deuteronomy 27:17. Cursed be he that removeth his neighbor's landmark. And all the people shall say,
man. Yeah, they got monuments down here on the bottoms on the west side of where the president, one of the old presidents, I forget what president was.
Isaiah 14:17 too.
He made a peace treaty with the Indians. There's a big monument over there commemorating about how they made peace with the Indians. But where are the Indians at? Where did they go?
Where all this is going to, man? America's about to be destroyed. You see America's over there in the Middle East. You see them in Ukraine, causing havoc in Ukraine, Syria, Libya, Yemen. I mean, where else they ain't at, man, you know? They're trying to force the EU into build, increasing their military budget. Plus, they're getting ready for World War III. With America?
It's going to be a world
America's
war.
Going against who? Everybody.
North Korea said world a Trump, if America fires one bullet, he's launching nukes.
That's it.
They got nukes too, NATO.
And World War III is going to end to the destruction of all this land.
And Trump's so stupid, he turned his back on NATO, they're going to turn their back on him.
Well, that's scripture. That's biblical.
Right.
Because biblical prophecy is that America's allies is going to turn their back on World War III.
You see what happened with him and Merkel, because Germany ain't no joke, you know what I mean? And you see how he refused to shake her hand and all that, being real nasty towards her. He's just making more enemies.
Right.
America's made a lot of enemies. So it's only a matter of time, you know what I mean?
I can tell you.
The fat lady's about to sing.
No,
you know what I mean?
Well, good luck to you guys. I'm working hard on the justice thing every day.
You're working hard.
I'm one individual.
You try to help people, right?
I'm one guy. Every day I try to help somebody. I really do.
Okay.
And I don't think anybody's trash.
Next trouble I get in, I'm going to call you up and have you represent me for free then. You know, because I've been accused, 50 years old, and I've been through that system for nothing many a time.
I can't stay here and say we always get it right every single time.
Just
sometimes
us.
Sometimes the rich guy does get a better shape. That's not right.
Definitely not right, but it's reality.
He's so crazy. He's so crazy.
All right, guys. I'll talk to you
okay,
next
man.
Time.
Okay, man. All right.
All right, bro. All right. Yep. Hey, at least he was nice enough to stop and talk to us.
I see something for you. Yeah. Jake be over here.
The dude was tall as hell too, wasn't he?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, what
I'm
saying, bro? What y'all saying is bullshit.
You know what I'm saying?
Y'all so fucking.
Oh, shit. She's not gonna get it until tomorrow.
That's Jake's favorite word when he's talking to us, ain't it? That's some bullshit, though.
Right.
Hey, Esau, man, here. He tried to. Yeah, he's slick with his shit. That's that smooth. His words are smoother than butter.
He ain't know what to say, man. He didn't know where the fuck we was at. He was just totally caught off.
Because that really cut his spirit when we met, brought about how the rich man versus the poor man in the justice system. You can see that really cut him right there. Because you know that's true, man. That's some fucked up shit.
Man, everybody know that, man. He was actually trying to get dumb.
Yeah. Well, he's part of the brotherhood. And like he was
admitting it on the low low.
Yeah, he was.
He was being
he did admit it. Like right. The Freemason thing. He admitted that pretty much.
Sucking dick.
He's like
plugged in ass.
Because a Freemason, you're not allowed to tell people you're part of this and that. Only if you do the proper handshake. And that's how you reveal yourself, you know what I mean? They got special handshakes and stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's why I hate shaking.
Yeah, because that's part of the reason. The whole handshake is Freemasonic on origin.
Right.
You know what I mean? You ain't supposed to be shaking hands. The Bible says to give somebody a salute. Oh, we might do the dap or whatever. I barely even do that.
Yeah.
When I see y'all, I just be like, you know, what's up?
Yeah, I mean, what these motherfuckers' hands been anyway?
Right. Could have been just jacking off.
Fisted all kind of motherfuckers.
Just took a shit, didn't wash their hands. Man, Jake is nasty, man. All these people is nasty. Over there grabbing their nuts all day, playing with himself.
Yeah, I don't.
What's up, bro? You know Jake can't keep his hands out of his pants. He a nasty motherfucker. And he'll come up and be like, what's up, bro?
That Bible, bro, paving the way for the Lord, man.
Yep.
Destruction is on its way. Literally, destruction is on its way.
Tell me something.
You know, America's about to be destroyed. And before America gets destroyed, our people are going to go through some fucking hell. It's all about the Lord. The Lord wants these motherfuckers to pay for their wickedness, man. You know, simple as that, man. The Lord wants these motherfuckers to pay for their wickedness.
And
our people, some evil motherfuckers.
And he hears everybody else.
Evil. Is it our people? Our people. Not fuck the white man. It's supposed to be evil.
No, you're saying it's just a cultural
our
race.
Our people.
Race culture.
Right. It's a cultural thing to be a wicked nigga. It's a cultural thing. They got fair niggas like Farrakhan teaching that falsehood, trying to rouse these motherfuckers up to unite under some wicked shit. You know what I mean? People ain't gonna unite, man. Our people ain't supposed to unite. You got something?
You don't think so?
Oh, no. Nah, we ain't supposed to unite, man. That comes out every week, man. It's kind of funny how this comes out all every week, man. Our people ain't supposed to unite. The elect of the Lord who's seeking the Lord in sincerity and truth. Sincerity and truth. Not some truth and truth. 100%. are going to unite. And that's the elect. That's what the Bible speaks of, that great multitude that it speaks of in the book of Revelation, the seventh chapter. You want to get it?
I got a question to ask.
Go ahead, bro.
If we in America, right?
Right.
We have our own perspective of what religion we're supposed to go by. For another person that's in another nation, another continent, would you say that their God is wrong?
Well, yeah. Can you explain that?
But this word, though, is global. This ain't just an American thing that we're doing. This, we got brothers all over the earth.
Understandable.
And that's why
I used to live in Germany.
Oh, yeah.
I used to live in Japan.
Right. So that's the reason why
I ask that question, because it's like, you know, how can I say that me being American, that I'm just right?
Well, no, it don't matter where I'm at.
Yeah, it don't matter where
you're
at. In a sense, though, because
the Israelites are scattered everywhere.
Right. The history of what was brought here was taken over, right?
What history was taken over?
The slavery and everything that happened here,
okay.
It was taken over,
right?
That's why we got Thanksgiving, Thanksgiving.
Right,
yeah.
Okay, so if it was
that would have been Thanksgiving? Go ahead.
You know, if it was taken over, then the way that I was brought up was not of my people teaching. It was what was put over my head.
Right.
The only way I see.
Right.
You know, but if I go down the street, I get a different perspective because I'm not this close.
I understand.
I can barely see, right?
Right.
And that's why I was asking that question. It just gets to, I'm a researcher.
Remember how you walked up to us and you asked what we was all about?
Right.
We out here to bring you back to your natural heritage. We're out here to bring you back to your natural inheritance.
I mean, Israel is true.
Right.
Israel is true. Let me see.
There's traces of Israel all over the earth.
What about the Moors?
Moors were Israelites.
Okay, you got it right here.
Right.
Well, that's not Moors. Not a nationality though. Moor was more of a.
Moors not a nationality?
Nah. Moors is a Moor just. That's really? Where he, Moor just means color. It's the color brown.
Just like you.
Hugh,
that,
Hugh.
Right.
Right.
But the Moor just means like Moreno. Like, it means brown.
A few minutes ago.
But that's not a nationality.
I'm gonna show you it's a nationality.
It can't. Moor's
not a nationality.
It's a nationality.
No, Moor's
it's a color.
Not a nationality.
It's,
right.
A color.
When,
like
when
black,
you speak it to a
white,
Spanish,
that's the same thing as Negro.
Moreno.
Moor means
mulatto.
A
right.
Mulatto. You know.
Negro means the same thing as Moor. It means brown.
Negus.
Yeah. Right.
Meaning king.
Oh, no.
Who?
We were watching some Bobby Heaven.
Yeah, that's wrong.
Bobby Heaven? Well, no, actually, I was, I learned under John Henry Clark.
Okay.
You know, I watched a lot of his lectures when he was debating these universities.
Right.
And he was tearing them down.
Right.
So it's like,
he got some knowledge, though.
Should I take the perspective of somebody that not know, meaning like the people that's in the schools that's teaching us this doctrine, or the people that was really pushing the knowledge so people can know. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
John Henry Clark, he did a lot of amazing things. He wrote a lot of books.
Right.
And
books.
What's crazy to
all
me
the
is,
them books.
What's crazy to me is, I go with nature. I don't subscribe to no religion just because if I gotta
we
say
we ain't got that, no religion though.
If I gotta say that my God is better than your God, then that must mean I still wanna teach this divide.
We don't believe that though, because there's only one God.
Yeah. Exactly.
And we don't teach religion either.
We're not that religion.
Well, I'm not. Go ahead.
Scripture says all the gods of the nations are idols, but the God of the Bible made heaven. Pretty much, all these gods of Japan and all this shit, they're all worship. They're all
not gods. They don't even exist.
Well, could you
and actually, paganism is a worship of the nature. And like Thor, the god of thunder, represents the thunder. You know what I mean?
Thor and for Thursday.
Right, like the Greeks. Yeah, Thursday, Woden's Day, yeah, all that. But like the Greeks, they had a different god for every natural occurrence.
Right, but that was Greek mythology.
But right, all the pagan mythology is all interwoven.
That was us.
That wasn't the Israelites invented that.
That was us.
Can you tell me why they had a council in Nicaea at 325,
that was
356
us.
AD?
That was us.
It was over the heresy of Arianism.
Arianism. Arian was the only person that was speaking the teaching of
the God is not
Osiris or Set and Isis.
He didn't teach that.
He did.
No, he didn't.
He did.
Arian taught that the reason they had a council in Nicaea because Arian taught against the Trinity. He said that the one
the mother, the father, the son.
But he said that Jesus is not God himself,
Emmanuel,
but the Son
Yeshua,
of God.
Jesus.
Right, but he didn't believe in no divorce or none of that, bro.
Right. He did.
Right.
No, he
didn't.
I can show. Right. Can I show proof?
You
okay, well, can I show a reference that I got it from?
We're already
besides saying my opinion.
Exactly.
I'm not against nobody.
Right. We're aware of all that. We're aware of people that try to say Israel means ISIS, Ra, El, and all that.
I never said that.
We know about that.
Or Israel, does follow other Islam.
16.
Actually, even America was based off of Islam before the
we heard about that.
Before the friendship tree.
Because originally, what happened with the Moors?
Morocco.
Yeah, Morocco. You see why the Moors today, they wear the red fez caps. You seen that?
Yes.
The red hats. That represents the Muslims murdering the Israelite so-called Christians and then dipping their hats in the blood of the Israelites. And that's why they wear the shrine.
Still wearing the cherry tree.
Huh?
Cherry tree. Chopping down the cherry tree.
Well, I don't know about that, but I'm talking about the fez cap.
That's the representation of the fez, of chopping down
the
cherry
tree. Oh, that probably is some Freemasonic shit. Yeah,
but the Moorish science is also from Masonry.
Well, it's all interwoven because the Moors, though, the Moorish science go back to the Ottoman Empire. Because that was the Ottomans, which were Edomites, with the so-called white people.
Now, was the Moors...
What's the ones that
took Europe out of the Dark Age?
No, that's not true. Why is it called the Dark Age?
I mean, can you explain to me?
Because Israelites ruled through Europe all that time. All that shit about they didn't have no technology. It's all bullshit. all the greatest cathedrals,
so
buildings were built.
That must mean that John Henry Clark, Joseph Ben Yekinen,
it's all wrong.
How?
Because the black during the Dark Age, that was us moving.
You see all those?
We were
there.
In power.
There.
That was us.
So, are y'all familiar with Cornell University?
Yeah.
Cornell University shows in DNA genetics shows that the first humans was pure humans was the Africans. No. And that everything goes.
That's wrong.
I mean,
they manipulate that.
I'm only going with facts, right?
Right.
According to the time that a victor had set the time for it to say 2017, but dinosaurs millions of years.
2017 what?
2017. Hold on. That must mean there's 2017 years of recorded data that we use as history today.
But 2017 years after what?
No, I want to say that to say this. I'm only 30. So what do I know based off of it being 2017
AD.
So what? It don't matter.
No, it matters though. I just want to get to that's a good point though, because time itself is based on the Bible. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
And the Bible's
the truth. That's why we got.
And they're trying to change it.
That's why we got the Middle East, but that was still a part of Africa.
But now the universities.
They even say Egypt was a part of the Middle East, but you can see it clearly it was in Africa.
Well, whatever. That's just.
Why I mentioned Egypt?
Right.
No.
We got Egyptian.
But what
it doesn't
I'm saying
matter
to you,
if it's Egyptian, but the history that was recorded there is still in our Bible.
But check this out. Why did the university? This is a good question.
It was not so big. Romans was not in Africa.
It was right by Africa. No, actually, the Roman Empire, they controlled large pieces
You're
of land.
Right, because the Potomac came down and took it over by military
But the
source.
Romans have been there even since then.
And that was the white genocide.
You said it in the Bible like it.
The Bible says that.
Don't get me wrong, but let's see. I don't know where is that per se by heart.
Came from the Bible.
If you want to ask my question, if you want to ask about my opinion, the metal necklace is the oldest relic of any history recorded.
Because it's old, don't mean it's
the what?
Okay, well, you know, if that's the case, then could you say you're better than your grandfather? So if that's the case, then that must mean.
But actually,
anybody who
because now you're just confirming the Bible, because the Bible tells you that Israel was one of the last nations, created.
That's right.
That confirms it.
Okay.
Because that is being
I'm not delineating.
Check that out.
Any other information?
Shit, hey, scientists today are smarter than scientists back in the day.
Seriously, then why they're not making the pyramids like they was today?
Oh, come on.
I was just saying, but that's a fact. Is that not a fact?
Now,
they didn't have ICBMs.
Did they have
free energy?
Did they have ICBMs?
Maybe you had
learned. They had technology. We agree, though. We know they had high technology, a different kind of technology.
They was already nuking.
Nah, but yeah, they ain't got...
Okay, well, put like this. Put like this, sir. Yeah. Put like this,
that was a Lord that did that.
Right. Put like this.
We know they had technology back then, bro.
Right.
We know that. We know that.
My uncle is from Kenya. And he takes us back and forth, and he gives us information. Not only have I been to Africa or Egypt, my mother has. That's the reason why I got there. But to know because you went there to see it is differently from getting a perspective just being here. You get me? So it's like, I can understand that information, but if it's not dug deep, like knowing the etymology of these words that's broke down so we can never have a different interpretation, then we're all gonna have a different mindset of what we're speaking about. And that's true.
Hey, but we read the scripture for you.
The etymology of words is broke down so you would know the geographical location of where these things happen,
what's Egypt's real name? In the...
Actually, they had a lot.
What's their main name, though?
I don't know.
Say Kemet, right?
They say Kemet.
But in the Bible,
they say it was one of them.
But in the Bible, that's what it's called. It's Kam. It's Kam, which means burnt. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it means the land of the black, the land of the gods.
But back then, all people were black, though.
Exactly.
All the nations.
Exactly. So what happened?
Well, there's a lot of things that happened. First of all, you got the plague of leprosy. They tell you about the Israelites catching leprosy in the scripture.
Well, check this out. If you be in the sun so long, even before you knew what melatonin was, you'll get it. Because you will be in the sun so long.
That ain't true.
That's not true.
Jews over there right now. The Jews over there.
They ain't got no.
No, that didn't have nothing to do with what I'm saying. Scientifically, nature. If you stand out here in the sun, you will get these spots. If you go out here to Florida, you will burn.
But
that's not saying anything from the book. That is coming from a natural.
Yeah, but skin color is not based upon geographic location though. Because you got dark. Because you got black Eskimos that live in the same place as the Vikings.
That does not mean that they was different. That does not mean that it was different.
Well, what I'm saying,
if I can't say that y'all are my brothers, right? That means that I'm saying that I don't look at y'all as a different species, a different race, a different ethic. You know, I don't look at it like that. I can't be racist, or I can't be saying like, oh, that
Mexican
is not my brother. That Caucasian person is not my brother. You know, that's just setting another division. I'm just not religious. So if I just say, okay, I want to say that's like saying everybody is a Hebrew Israelite. I mean, are you laughing at me?
You check it out, man.
No, hey, no, fuck
listen,
that. Are you laughing at me?
Listen, bro.
Are you laughing at me, man? That's disrespectful.
Listen, man. Listen, man.
Fuck what you talking about,
seriously, man. Come here. Come on, man. Come on, man.
That shit right there gets your bitch ass knocked out.
We ain't trying to be cool with you, bro.
Right, not trying to be cool with y'all, but it seemed like
So you ain't never kicked it with your friends and start laughing, having a good time, laughing at each other.
Is that the type of conversation that we're having? Cause for you to laugh in somebody's face, that's an insult. Don't.
They're trying to fight somebody's an insult,
don't
bro.
Don't think that I don't have it. I'm not intellectual.
You feel what I'm saying?
Just like y'all feel with a friend. Don't disrespect me. I ain't come to
but
y'all.
You talking about
my voice.
So talk.
I ain't do none of that shit.
Just your boy just laughing at me.
It's just like this right here.
I'm
sick of this bitch ass knocked out.
Come on, bro. Come on, man. Just sit
down. You was talking about be a unity and all that, but you want to cause violence, harm to somebody.
Okay, then, but I respect you enough to not laugh in your face.
But it ain't
nobody laughing at you, man.
Ain't nobody laughing at you, bro. You said something that was funny. Man. People laugh sometimes.
And what was funny?
It's just the way you said it,
what
bro.
What is funny?
Come on, bro.
No, I didn't know what was funny.
You're being unreasonable.
No, because I'm not laughing at y'all. If y'all said something crazy, I'm going to ask what it was besides just laughing your face. You don't do nobody like that,
come
man.
Come on, man.
It ain't really that serious, bro.
Yeah, you just taking shit too far, bro.
I don't know.
We out here kicking it with you.
Person,
what was you out here cussing
I'm
at
not
you?
No disrespectful person,
you disrespect. That was disrespectful.
Hell yeah!
Come on. That was crazy.
Hell yeah!
That was crazy.
All the way to the max.
That was real crazy.
And it wasn't even there
why
yet.
Why are you causing division?
Yeah.
Don't be hypocrite, man.
And confused.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look, man, look at y'all trio trying to double team, man. Come on, man.
Look, personally,
see, now we can laugh. You get what I'm saying?
Now we're trying to keep peace.
When I was just speaking, it was a laugh. You get what I'm saying? It was a laugh. You get what I'm talking about?
Are you serious right now?
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Was that all necessary?
Or do you overstand what I'm saying?
Was that all necessary?
Are you still getting what I'm talking about?
No, we don't understand what you're saying.
Okay, that's better than to not say nothing, right?
What the hell? That was unnecessary.
Wait, what was unnecessary?
Like, all you gotta do is talk.
No, hold on, but put it like this, put it like this. Do I know you? Do you know me? So righteously, we gotta give each other the common courtesy of respect. So I'm not gonna laugh in your face. Even if anything you think that I'm funny about, then hey, you need a question that.
I just don't get it.
That's fucking wrong.
Well, hey, it's supposed to be this way.
I get a, what was that, Jeremiah?
Oh, where the come from?
Oh, yeah. Hey, shit, we might have to get these signs out here. They're gonna get fucked up. It ain't.
Is this your home? What is that? This is my brother. Notice. This nationality and identification declaration.
Oh, so that's zoomed in. I'm zoomed out.
Sorry.
I got zoomed out a little bit. Shit. Damn it. What the hell was it zoomed out?
Decorate.
Yeah, push it the other way.
They ain't
going?
I think I lost it. I don't know where that. Oh, there it is.
Character. I was on American National Identification
Card.
I mean, what is this, though? What is it?
Nationality. You are more
right. Right, but that's this world's nationality. That's this world's nationality.
If you understand
what I'm saying? See, Lord already named every nation.
Right,
that's
and
what
more,
you got
more,
is this name.
More is in there.
More is in what?
Listen, just the same way you showed me that,
the
sir.
The Moors were Israelites.
Just the same way you showed me this right
exactly.
here.
Exactly.
I have that same thing.
Okay. And,
you know, I have that same thing.
But the Moors were Israelites who got caught up in Islam.
Right. We were, we went off. We broke
in
the covenant.
And the Moors, they did have a lot of the top universities in the world at that time, too.
So,
we know that. We know that.
Tell me, where did we get Indians from?
Which Indian?
American.
American Indians, those were Israelites.
Okay. So,
Gadites,
okay,
Seminole Indians, so
those
are Israelites.
All these ones that you speak,
get Second Ezra 6,
are Moors people. Right. All these Indians that was here is Moors people. Did you say
no? They're not Moors.
Think about what you told to me earlier. You said, well, the Moors are the Israelites. Right?
Oh my bad, man.
Moors aren't Israelites. Though.
Okay, so if you can. Say for a fact that Moors are Israelites,
right?
Then these Indians are right. The same people.
But look, by that time, the Native American Indians were here. They were already here.
Yeah.
See, the 10 tribes.
So you're talking about like the Aztec, the Mayans.
Listen. The Israelites were split up into two groups. Okay. The Native American Indians, led by the Ephraim, the so-called Puerto Ricans. They were already on this side in the Western Hemisphere. But the so-called black man, the last three tribes were still over there. Okay?
But nobody was known as black colorable law came.
That's what Moors means, though.
When the colorable law came, that's when they was like, African-American, Dominican, Indian, you know what I'm saying? It was pointed out, and all you gotta do is just Google it. Colorable law, and it teaches you this. I get energized with this because
we energized too. That's why we out here.
History, world history cannot be separated from religion history. And that's what I see a lot. I see a lot because it's like, well, let's go into the Bible or let's go into the Hebrew scripture, or let's go into the Quran, or let's go into the I King.
But that's why the schools. But look, we was just talking about that. At school, they gonna teach you about Egyptian history, Greek history, but they don't teach you about the Bible history. It's forbidden from schools.
Read that, bro. Read this.
Tell me if I'm wrong or am I right.
The Bible history.
Tell me, am I wrong or am I right? Is the Bible forbidden and everything else is allowed? Think about that.
I mean, they did take that out. They did take that out.
Think about that, bro.
But hold on, though. They never talked about the Moors.
But they talk about Egypt, though.
But they never talked about the Moors.
You're right. They won't talk about the Moors.
They never talked about the Berbers. They never talked about Blackfoot. They never talked about the black ones that first hit Japan, or the ones that was in China, the Buddhists. They never talked about these things. But I got to say this right here. Why they never talk about the books that is missing out of what we know now as the Bible?
He's about to read one. He's about to read one.
So what is this? Adam and Eve?
The Apocrypha.
It's 2nd Exodus 13 and 40. These are the 10 tribes.
Go ahead, bro.
The King James Apocrypha.
This is 16 and 11.
But they took it out, these devils, they took it out the Bible back in the 1800s.
Right.
Go ahead.
Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land.
Now this is telling you about that the so-called, what they call the lost 10 tribes. But the scriptures tell you where they went. Go ahead.
In the time of Uzziah, the king whom Salmanazar, the king of Assyria,
led
away captive, and he carried them over the river, the waters, and so came there into another land.
They
took this counsel among themselves that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country. Where America, never that mankind
country and that further country where never mankind dwelt. It said where land
did it say again?
Where never mankind dwelt.
That was the Americas.
That's Americas.
Right. The Western Hemisphere.
Because when they first came over here, you had Canaanites that came over here, was mining resources and stuff. But really nobody really lived over here before the Israelites got over here.
We came over here to mine.
Yeah,
we sent slaves over here to mine.
So what about the Almonds?
The Olmecs. That's who we sent
slaves over here to mine. Those are the Canaanites.
Right. We sent miners over here to mine for gold.
They were Canaanites.
Diamonds, jewels, stones.
Okay.
Furs.
Because the Olmecs came before the before the Aztecs and all them, and before the Mayans.
Correct.
Because those were the Canaanites, but the Mayans and then those were Israelites. See what I'm saying?
Israelites. But there came a time when we all broke that covenant with the Lord. We started following after other gods.
The scriptures tell you about King Solomon. He had a whole fleet of Canaanite ships that he used to go over here to get resources.
I hear a lot of, this is my opinion, okay?
Go ahead, man.
This is my opinion.
Go ahead.
Gotta say that. How it is the truth and the lie that we read. That the perspective that we're learning from is only from one way because of where we're getting the information from.
Right.
For me to speak English, my tongue was changed.
All of us.
I'm gonna get this on the camera.
Okay, and of course, it's gonna be there.
Right.
It's gonna be there. But what's not gonna be there is that, for instance, Dr. Saith. Anybody familiar with him?
No.
Who? Yeah, he just passed away, didn't he?
August 6, 2016.
Yeah.
He
was real good with nutrition and stuff.
This man showed that in 1988, he went to the Supreme Court because he put an ad in the newspaper for curing AIDS, asthma, HIV, lupus, sickle cell, and more.
The cure.
Yeah, he's the one that made that really brought out the truth about acidic diet versus the alkaline diet.
I know who he is now.
Alkaline diet.
Yeah.
Okay, so check this out, y'all.
And he was right on that.
He was. But think about this. If he was so right, then nobody should be diabetic right now.
Right.
Nobody should be eating meat right now.
Well, meat ain't gonna make you diabetic.
Yes, that's one source of mucus.
Well, you can eat meat. You can't, you gotta have, there's a balance. Remember the balance of things?
Okay,
I don't eat meat.
Chapter 1, Genesis. Chapter 1, verse 29.
Go ahead.
States that the trees that bear the fruits will be used as your meat.
Yeah, right.
Chapter 1, verse 30 said the same command to the animals.
And the Lord also commanded us to eat the lamb
after
on the Passover.
Noah, the story of Noah, there was no vegetation on the land for them to eat. Now, I got a good question. If you are in Europe and the sun doesn't create enough energy to create the vegetation on the land, then you do not eat nothing but meat and flesh. If you was in a tropical like Africa, Australia, or even over here, but it still got four seasons here, you was eating of the trees, of the fruits of the land. Why is it that science is different? Meaning science, y'all don't believe in science.
Well,
science, do not believe in science.
Science means knowledge. We do believe in knowledge.
Correct. But to say that, But to say that the science of the body anatomy, how the body function, to know that we are electrical people, to put something dead in your body, what are you feeding your body to possess?
Look, I'm going
to
tell you something. I'm a vegetarian, bro. I don't eat meat.
I am too.
But I'm going to tell you something. Every once in a while, I had to, because you don't get no vitamin B12 if you don't eat meat.
That's why we ate fish.
Vitamin B12.
Go look it up, because your bones and shit start...
Dr. Savior even said vitamin B12 does not exist.
Oh, it don't exist?
Seriously.
I can't argue with that, bro.
I don't know. I don't know if it does or not.
Like,
well, I'm just telling you.
Watch his lectures. I'm pretty sure you have watched a lot of his lectures, but watch his lectures, man. Because that's what I do, man. I've been studying Dr. Savior for 4 years, man, and I helped my mother get right off of thyroids.
Yeah.
And I don't know what I'm doing.
Right.
But I just took note of watching the body. You get what I'm saying?
Because
she didn't want to do perms, and she wanted to do perms, and that was another way of females getting thyroid.
What about omega-3? You know what I'm saying? What's it called? Omega-3 acids?
Yeah, from the, they come from the fish. Come from the fish oils. Yeah.
Amino acids, omega-3s, right?
Right. Right. But like the brother said, there's a balance, though. There's a balance to it.
You eat more greens than meat.
Yeah, because we always
eat.
But we got to. Why? Why do we have to? So we have to balance the sickness that's developing in our body. The more meat that you eat, the more that you... Put it like this. You eat some meat. And I done did this, man. I done ate some meat. It's cold. I gets buildup. I got asthma.
Right.
Anything that's a mucus buildup gets me to my lungs to contract to where I cannot breathe. Now, when I eat cabbage, when I eat jalapenos, when I eat a lot of fruit, I don't have that same symptom in my body.
Right.
And then I have a lot more energy where I can stay up almost 24 hours and not be tired or drained.
Right, we know that. I mean, we eat a shit ton of greens, bro. But I can't gonna say someone's evil or not because they eat meat. You know what
right,
I mean?
Right.
I'm not saying that they.
But you know what I mean?
I'm not saying that they're evil, but they just say lack of knowledge is the reason why they're getting sick. Lack of knowledge
all
is
right.
The reason why.
And a lot of shit they eating too is not even cold cuts. They eating processed meat.
GMO, genetic modified organisms.
The way they raise these animals is disgusting. You know what I mean?
And Cornell University also showed that a cow was never a real animal. A horse was never a real animal. No, that they was playing God. Just like corn. Corn is not a real food.
Corn is synthetic. Corn is pretty much a right. The way they domesticated the corn cannot survive without humans. It has to have human intervention to keep living.
Correct.
Because it can't even plant its own seeds.
It was made just to feed the farm animals.
Right.
You know, so it's like the complication here is that since we don't know that and we was only doing what we was told because that's how we was taught, then we're
going to hit you with something though. But I'm going to hit you with something though. Because even they say the same thing about bread and ergot, but that was the most.
Bread too.
But you know, I was saying though, that's
the yeast.
But that's and the ergot too. It got ergot in it. But that's the Most High created all that and showed us the knowledge of how to grow these things. Because, you know what I'm saying? Because the Most High gate. It tell you when Noah first got off the ark. What's the first thing Noah did when he got off the ark?
Got fucking drunk.
Well, what did he do though?
He grew
a vineyard, because he was a husbandman. You know what I'm saying? So first thing he did, he started growing his grapes, got his crops going, and that's why the scriptures always talk about how the Israelites, you know, that's where the knowledge of growing these crops and breeding these different. And it is even scriptures in the Bible that tell you that you're not allowed to cross the two different species of plants together.
Correct.
It has a law.
Right.
You know what I mean? We're not allowed to do that.
But you know, it was also too a law that to burn books, burn history. Timbuktu had the world largest library, and a lot of the relics of there is stuffed in the Catholic.
Well, you know
the Vatican.
You know the Vatican got all that.
right. That, so we're because
you know they got the history of the Mayans, because they burned all the Mayans books too. They said they did.
Now check this out. For you to say the Mayans.
Because they're going to erase any trace that they were the Israelites down there. Because this is all Jake's.
So the
Israelites.
What about the crossing? Passing over. The Israelites passing over. Why is that a saying for the Israelites?
I'm about to get to
you mean death? Well.
I mean that. You're talking about the Passover.
Yes.
The Passover.
But that was the angel of death passing over. That tells you that. But the reason it's called the Passover is because, I think you took come from that word, Ibar. The word Hebrew means over in the Hebrew tongue. Every time you say, even the English word over comes from the Hebrew word Ibar. It's very similar. V's morph into V's in languages. So the word over in English comes from the Hebrew word Ibar, or Hebrew. And that means over. Because,
man, they smoking that dank. We thought you'd smoke something the way you went off.
That's why I need to smoke some. I need to smoke some. But I'm with nature, you guys, man. And you know what?
The thing is, a Hebrew Israelite, regardless, at the end of the day, you are a Hebrew Israelite.
You say that, right?
Right.
But that must mean that, okay, then for these 12 tribes,
right?
Out of all these 12 tribes, I'm the one that's an Israelite.
You an Israelite,
But there is 12 tribes.
Because I'm in America,
we all in America.
I'm just saying, but meaning that I'm just stating that because of the statement of being in America, you are automatically an Israelite.
How can you say that I, as
an Israelite, because it was based off of scripture.
But
put it like this: if you was manipulated, if you was deceived,
that was us. That's
in
Israelite.
All things, then. How can you say that then?
Because the curses fit us. The curses that are in the Bible only fits us. Dude, what you getting first?
Leviticus, scattered.
Right, that's it.
So what about the people that, what about Iraq?
Listen.
There's Israelites over there too.
Okay.
They don't know the Israelites though.
What about Australia?
Israelites over there.
But they don't know they're Israelites.
But listen to what you're saying. So where's the other 11?
We don't know. They're scattered everywhere.
So we know, but
just listen.
I'm just saying, but why I'm not that?
But you are that. You just don't know.
So I'm all
of them. No, you're one of them.
One of the tribes.
Listen, just read.
We all lost our identity.
Right.
Leviticus.
Genetics then loses identity.
Listen, brother.
Leviticus 26:33. I will scatter you among the heathen. And withdraw a sword after you, and your land shall be desolate, and your cities waste.
Right.
Okay, that is cool, but y'all got it.
Let me hit you with this.
The Israelites are the most numerous people on the planet Earth.
Jeremiah.
Okay, they're more numerous than the sands of the seashore, and more numerous. Listen, they're more numerous than the sands of the seashore, and more numerous than the stars of heaven. Okay, we are the most numerous people on Earth, and it's not determined by skin color. You know what I'm saying? Cause you said you was in Japan, right? So you probably met some cool ass people in Japan, right?
Yeah, but I also know that the first black people was there. I also know that.
Right. So those was Israelites over there.
Listen to this scripture.
Listen to what y'all telling me, man. Y'all saying that,
listen.
The other 11 tribes, you know what I'm saying?
Look, check this out.
Israelites is everywhere.
No, but listen. There's even a documentary on YouTube that goes into the Japanese language and their alphabet and shows you how it derives from Hebrew.
I can show otherwise.
Listen, read.
Jeremiah 17:4.
Polite, that dude is CIA.
And thou, even thyself, shall
start over.
So it's the things that he says CIA too?
Come on, let's stay on point, man.
Jeremiah 17:4. And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine inheritance.
Say it again.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage.
Shall discontinue from thy heritage. And your heritage is the Hebrew Israelite.
Okay. All right.
Is that all?
Why we never...
Cause thee to serve thy enemies in a land which thou knowest not, for ye have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever.
See, we going off, so the Lord punished us.
He said he gonna
scatter us on the four corners of the earth. So some of us growing up in Japan, China, Iraq, Africa, Australia, America.
That still does not make me an Israelite.
You an Israelite.
You even had
you are an Israelite.
And what's that?
You got the spirit of an Israelite. You act like an Israelite.
I represent the metal nature of nature.
That tells you.
My holy trinity is the Mother, the Father, and the Son. I do not consult or do anything that has something to do with the Father, the Ghost, and the Son.
Well, that proves Israelite did that in the ancient world. They always went after other gods and shit.
Hey. Right. I don't go against other gods.
Right.
Nature. No. Okay. Put it like this. Right now, can you go against nature? Cause you're in it right now. We in nature right now, right? You're breathing in nature. You're getting soaked by nature. Nature is the almighty God.
You better leave Pilate alone, man.
That's not who I just got the information from. I do my own studies.
So what about the spirit? Documents. What about the spirit?
Now, as far as the inner me,
who created that nature?
So what animates you?
What you mean? What animates you?
You
talking about as far as
the
soul?
What gave you a soul and a conscience, and you be able to even to discuss these things?
Think about this.
Where does that come from?
If I never had a book, how would I even know these things?
But that's it.
Because natural.
But everybody
nature,
does have books.
You don't need a book to study nature, understand the science of nature.
But the Lord gave us books. He gave us writing.
Man chopped down tree, and that was wrong. You chopped down a tree to make a book, but by nature of God, because of what they did in Egypt, what they did in Sudan, what they did in Nubia, was they went with according to nature. And that's where the science came from. But I love to study. I love my history. And that's the only way I can say it.
Without history, without writing, though, you can't even know history. And then you'd be on the level of an animal, and we are above the animals, and we are the masters of all creatures on this earth. That's why a man can tame a lion, and a lion will obey his every command, because the Lord has given us mastery over the creatures of the earth.
Okay, you're right on that, right? You're right on that.
And the animals respect us.
No. All these things that you speak is still coming from the coffin text. All these things that you speak from here is still coming from the hieroglyphics, what they call the metal nature. So what I want to understand is that how is that all these relics of religion still coming deprived right out of the same place that they say, hey, Egypt was wrong. Hey, Africa was bad. Hey, they did wrong. How is that? Because we're not there.
But who are even?
We're not there.
You can read the histories though, and they tell you that the Egyptians got the knowledge of astronomy from Abraham. And Egypt was made.
Okay, then tell me who was Tutmosis. Then you're gonna tell me who Moses is. So
Tutmosis ain't Moses.
How?
You can't prove it. No,
I can't prove it.
First of all, where
I can't prove it.
Because the name.
Because the name is Moses. It. That's a common name in Egypt.
Tutmosis was a common name.
There's a lot of Tutmosis.
Really?
Well, Moses. You got Moses, Tup Moses, all these different Moseses.
Okay.
Because it means drawing out the water.
So, which is still going back to this right here. You have a relic of 12 to 32 years, 1,000 years, compared to what we know as the 1611 Bible that was translated through Hebrew, Arabic, and Greek, right? But that all was translated from the metal nature.
Nah, but hold on. It's nowhere similar.
If that was not the case, then the people who taught the Greeks the Egypt teachings would never exist. For Constantine to do what he did then, it would never been what we have today.
Constantine didn't do nothing.
If Constantine didn't, then who was Constantine? Was he a military leader?
He was an emperor.
Did he not push military? Did he not have an army?
Of course, he was an emperor.
Did he not doctrinize his people and give them a faith to believe in and say, if you believe in him, you would die. You will not die. He did not do this.
No, actually, the emperor that made Christianity the religion of the empire was actually Theodosius the First.
Okay, you talking about the fallacy.
No, Constantine. What Constantine did?
Do you know who the fallacy?
He decriminalized Christianity.
Do you know who the fallacy?
But he didn't make it the state religion.
Do you know who the phallacies are?
A phallic symbol, like Osiris.
No, phallus.
A fallacy.
That's like a last name.
A fallacy means something that's false.
The
penis.
The legacy of the Caesar.
Penis.
You can find a book called Joseph, and it's identical to the New Testament.
Book of Joseph.
Identical in the wars. Identical. The Book of Joseph.
Was
you gotta leave all these other books alone.
Oh, I got that.
Why? Think about what you're
saying. Where'd it come from, though?
Think about what you're saying.
Let me get to that Egyptian stuff, though.
That's what I'm saying, is a division, because if you're black and I'm white, right? Well, I'm just saying that it's a division because everybody has books. Everybody has some sort of history from Asia, from here, from.
But where does Egyptian history come from, though?
It comes from the
white man. It comes from the white man.
Egyptology.
Exactly. All
okay,
the,
then that's not.
You talking about Tutmosis, all these different pharaohs.
No. You cannot tell me that a white man made these people if they made Egyptology.
No.
Egyptology was the study of Egypt when they went into
what I'm saying,
and
though,
closed
all, down all the timelines.
To check out the hieroglyphics to know what these people was talking about. They named us gods. We didn't name us.
Are you ever heard of Ipuwer Papyrus?
Ipuwer Papyrus.
Well, before I get to the Ipuwer Papyrus.
On a Semitic text.
Well, before I get
to the Samaritan text.
Ipuwer Papyrus talks about the Exodus.
Yes,
it tells you the rivers
that
were blood.
From the papyrus papers?
Yeah.
Okay, then that's not older.
It was written in Egyptian.
Than the carbon.
Yes, it is.
That is Hebrew.
It dates over 3,000 years. It's after the time of
that's
Moses.
That's still not older than the metal nature.
But what I'm saying,
that's
though, it was written. It was written by Egyptian scribes, and it accounts the Exodus.
Okay.
And regardless, the Israelites built the Sphinx, built the pyramids.
Can we agree that Europe's made Egyptology?
No, what I'm saying.
My man, come help me. Hey, come through. Come through, baby.
Last time I talked to these guys, they told me I ain't know what the hell I was talking about.
My man. Really?
Yeah, the last time I talked to them, they swore to God I didn't know what I was talking about. The whole issue is that Bible and everything about that Bible still got some reference way beyond that Bible. Way beyond that Bible. Let's talk about spirituality and not the idea.
That's what we talk about, spirituality.
But the way y'all reference it, it's not that way.
Right.
It's not that way. It's about you trying to perpetuate an idea. That's the way y'all explain it. When it was explained to me a long time ago, the way y'all explained it to me the last time I talked to you, how y'all did it. Y'all was talking to me like it's an ideal as opposed to a lifestyle that was way beyond the words that come out there in the Bible. It's a whole lot of life way before the Bible, way before the common era and all of that. What about all of that knowledge before these words was written down that we supposed to adhere to in the way that y'all say it?
Okay, there was a time it was.
Don't make it true. What about the history of that? What about that?
There was a time where it was just oral.
When it was just oral? What about the time?
Was there a flood?
Right after it was written and it wasn't just oral.
But how does it make it true?
This is what makes it true. Everything you talk about in that book has to have a historical account. Most of what comes out of that book has no historical account.
Yeah, it does.
So you just made that up too.
It's not a history book. I'm actually, can you go in that Bible and pull out any date out of that Bible? That Bible.
Why couldn't they protect their patriarchs and bury them in a proper burial? They grave robbers them came and spoiled all their graves. While King David is sound asleep in a safe spot, in the safe zone. They didn't want to hear that one. Yeah, they always bring that tomb thing up, bro. But you kill that with Alexander. They never found Alexander's tomb. They never found Genghis Khan's tomb. Genghis Khan had one of the biggest empires the earth had ever seen. Where no tomb. No, you know why? Because they were smart enough to hide that shit. The Egyptians weren't, well, let's face it, they weren't they're Hamites. They ain't the smartest people on the planet.
Now
we gotta turn this off. Our camera's probably destroyed.
Too much rain, man.
All right, then.
It was just a bunch of rain.
Shalom.